Yeah, that's what they had said, and I just read that plaque.
And, you know, like we were saying too, discussing, you know, you have to imagine just energy carries on, right? Like, I mean, you know, this is what we are. And you would think that anybody who's loved performances here, or even who loved to perform here, and they too probably come back. This is where they were, like, cheered on. And if I had 2,000 people cheering me on every night for a couple weeks, I'd come back.
Yeah, why not?
So. It sounds like these are happy ghosts.
Yeah, they're good ghosts. They're not scary ghosts.
No, good energy.
So that's nice.
The jail, not good energy.
Yeah, I
don't. No.
Scary in there.
Very scary. Yeah.
So did they... Is there anyone here who's seen the ghosts?
Not apparently, but we talked earlier and they were saying that, you know, other people
they've heard. Work,
they've
heard.
And,
okay.
So, but nothing that's, no one that's here right now that's, had any direct experiences, I believe.
Well, we do know that there's a ghost. And she's very friendly and nice.
Yep. She's of the good kind.
Yeah.
Awesome. Doors open, events happening today everywhere. Like, there's actually more this year, I think, than there ever has been.
Mm.
So it's too bad it's not on longer because you can't get to everything.
Well, and we've done it a few times.
Yeah.
Like, he and I, this is the first time with the kids. Yeah. Cool. So we'll say thank you very much.
Thank you. First.
Here.
That's how we make our very important decisions.
Your next what?
My book. My next book will be a bestseller.
Oh, what do you write?
It says yes.
Oh, I do fiction.
It says yes. Mom, can I do one?
Here. My website isn't connected to those places.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
Like the shades of gray.
Better. Yeah, no, that because that book really that sucked. Yeah, I could not even get through the 30th page. I'm like, yeah, no, I can't do this. It's just horrible.
Yeah,
but good on you because I've tried to write that. It's very hard.
It is hard. Actually, I was writing a sci-fi fantasy and I was having a difficulty writing a dominant character, and I thought I should just try to write.
Yeah.
That to try
for sure,
and challenge
for sure.
myself, and then I published my first book.
Oh, good for
so
you.
I'm off my original.
And who's your publisher?
Yeah.
Oh, you self-publish.
I have 10
you
information.
Have. Yeah, write down your information if you don't mind. And I'd like to connect and find that out. That's good.
You asked what? For your birthday?
Yeah.
I'll come to your birthday.
Asking for
Oh, thank you. This is my pen name.
Okay.
I'm basically on Twitter mostly. I'm actually just starting to write a novel right on Twitter a lot.
Oh, nice.
Tomorrow or the next day.
Very nice.
And
good for you.
It's actually a choose your own adventure, so when I hit certain parts of the book, I'm leaving the voting open to the people so they'll get to choose what happens next.
Amazing.
Yeah,
wow.
And then already.
Yeah, proud of you. That's good.
I try something
nice.
I hope
that's
I can.
Cool.
I aspire to be that at one point. Spirits or any type of
encounters?
My boyfriend and I were on a dark country road, and all of a sudden there was this light beside us.
The ghost lights. Yeah.
And it scared us both.
Sure. And whereabouts? Was this Woodridge?
Southeast of Portage la Prairie.
Oh, the other side. Oh,
yeah. So we took off and headed back to town, and the light followed us for a while.
Really?
But we lost it. Few nights later, we were behind the apartment building that I lived in, and it was there again.
Beside the car again.
When I told my mother about it, she said, that was your guardian angel.
Oh, really? Yeah, that's weird that it came with you, though.
Yeah. Well, yeah. But that was the only time that ever...
Yeah.
That was it. Never saw that light again.
Very
saw the light at that time. And
yeah. And you're not that boyfriend, I guess.
No, I wasn't the light.
You're not the light. Maybe the light was warning her of the boyfriend.
Oh, could be.
Must have been.
Could have been. It happens for a reason.
I think so, yeah.
Well, thanks for sharing. All
right.
My name's Jazz.
Hi, Jazz. I just read.
Care to check us out?
All right, sure.
By all means. We're not everybody's cup of tea. We're like a shot of vodka or tequila. It all depends what you're interested in.
A little bit of gin on the side?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Of course.
Yeah.
Dry.
Yeah, all right, sounds good. Is this where you always broadcast?
No, we just put the doors open. Luckily enough, we did Dalnert yesterday. Very honored to go to the Dalnert Museum. Beautiful place. So we
Dalnert,
sorry. I spelled it wrong, too.
I used to volunteer there.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Do you know Mark Kettner?
It's years since I volunteered.
Oh, okay.
Back in the Dark Ages, the 1990s, not the 1890s.
Those are hard times.
Yeah.
We did that, but normally, aside from interviewing, we normally have like an office in my house and we do a quad lounge.
Okay.
This is, we don't make money. We just do this for the fun of it. We discover history, and we like the history element with the haunted, and we try to dispel stuff. We try to look and, you know, do more research and find out why is this happening, and we make light of things.
Have you been to the Vaughan Street Jail?
Yes,
we did yesterday. Yeah.
Were you there? We went there today.
Okay. Yeah.
And they said the fellow said this is it is.
Yeah.
The fellow said this is the most haunted part, and I just found it really closed in that space.
Yeah. We were fortunate enough, actually. Me and my this is my sit-in partner Jen. She's more like our videographer, I guess you would say.
Yeah.
Sure.
You're the Ann Jen.
I'm the Ann Jen.
Yeah. Okay. Sure. Yeah, had her parents' 50th last night, so I wouldn't expect that she.
I guess that's a good excuse. Yeah.
But we were lucky enough to pick down Kristen with Square Pig Tours. She does all the ghost tours, and the Vaughan Street Jail is her passion project. She does the Friends of Vaughan Street Jail. She's a good girl, nice girl. She's so busy, but we tried to nail her down for quite a long time to have an interview. Like, she's very instrumental with the ghost tours and just so informative. So we actually nailed her down. She says, well, you can come down when we're setting up Friday night. So me and Cher actually got a half an hour interview with her.
Oh.
Just her insightfulness on how she started and things she's
in the jail?
Everywhere, like Elmwood Cemetery.
No, that's where you had the interview.
Oh, yes, sorry. We had the interview in the jail.
So you had lots of company.
Yeah. Well, I was more focused in on her, you know. So
but you can be sure there was.
Oh, I'm sure there was, yeah. Like some of the pictures and stuff that she was showing us. And then we had another couple here earlier. They showed us a good picture. I'm going to show you this. They took this at the Vaughan Street Jail a couple years ago. I have a friend who had said that she had had green orbs in her pictures at the Vaughan Street Jails themselves. Called Giving Up the Ghost. Yeah. So we're here to see if anybody has any ghost stories to share, or if they just want to get in contact with us and tell us later on, because I know the tours are kind of busy and stuff, so. Yeah. You had your, how was that? You had your covers what?
My covers when I was I woke up and the covers just got pulled. I saw it being pulled down and didn't know what it was.
Wow.
I found that was really strange.
Is that the first time that it ever happened to you?
It happened twice. It happened a few months ago too.
Okay.
And then it happened another time when I was in Toronto visiting my brother.
Wow.
And yeah, you could actually see the covers being pulled down.
Right.
It's very odd.
That is very, I'd be disturbed about it too, you know, because then you know you're not alone or something,
yeah,
right?
That's right, eh?
Yeah. Sorry.
Okay.
Well, it's nice to meet you. Come back next after.
Okay.
For sure.
Ghost stories?
Yeah. Encounters, I guess.
Well, I had ghost encounters when I was younger, yeah.
Did you? Like in a house? Or?
Yeah, in my house, yeah.
You lived in a haunted house?
Well, we had a ghost that was in the house. He would turn off electricity whenever he didn't like somebody in our house.
Interesting. But that's all he would do, though? Like
no, he threw things, too.
Was an element or whatever you say, like just very forceful, very, yeah. Would you ever want to be interviewed about it, or
not? No? Huh?
That's okay. Some people are forthcoming about it,
and
some people just
want
to have nothing to do with it.
Wait,
I should ask you about Mabel.
Oh, about Mabel? Well, apparently, I guess her and her husband, they performed here, and they were loved so much that unfortunately when they went back to the home in England, they died, right? So they say that they came back to perform here. That's what they say. Mm-hmm. Did you really? Well, we're doing a podcast. You think you saw Mabel just now?
Uh-huh.
Did you? Was she wearing a white dress? Did you see her hair or her face or anything?
I saw her hair tied up in a bun.
Oh, that could be her.
Where was she?
She was I don't know how to explain it. Up like on the deck.
Yeah.
At the back of the second deck.
Really? Very cool. Wow. Yeah. You had a very special experience then, didn't you? That's nice. Did we give you a ghost?
Yeah.
You're welcome. Okay, thanks for coming and talking. What's your name, little girl? What's her name?
Kenzie.
Kenzie. Thanks, Kenzie. Yeah, great day. Do you want to share with us?
The podcast. This is awesome.
We are actually Winnipeg's first and only paranormal podcast. We've been doing this for like 19 weeks.
Okay.
So well, consecutively, sick. Like we keep doing it.
I'll listen to you guys. Yeah. I listen to like I don't know if you've heard them the last podcast on the left.
I don't like that one, but
no?
I have.
Okay.
No.
That's okay.
No. But we banter like that too. But we talk more about the hauntings and stuff in the city. I do like my favorite murder, of course. You know that. Have you ever heard that one? My favorite murder.
No.
That one's pretty good, but again, it's gruesome. We just like talking about the hauntings and stuff that's going on in Winnipeg, and we explore and we share and we sit around, we drink and eat and swear, and yeah, it's all good.
Sounds like a good.
Did you grab a card?
Yeah.
I will grab a card, yeah.
Here you go.
Thank you.
We're on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter as well.
April's like the podcast lady.
Yeah. Not really. I just listened to them one.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I just listened to the last podcast.
Oh, okay.
I found them funny.
Like, they're okay. There's five guys, right?
Yeah. Three.
Is it three?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because when I started listening, there was five, and it was just too much, eh? Like, there was just...
Oh, yeah, it's a lot.
Oh, yeah,
I couldn't
imagine
keep track
because
some of the voices sound the same, so,
yeah.
You know. But.
Yeah, they'd have the three main guys, and then, like, have, like, side stories. Like, they're,
right.
And they have, like, a different guy on there, too, so then there's, like, three of them. But it's, like, yeah.
Right.
But, I don't know. They keep it kind of, like, interesting because it's kind of funny, so they can't
it
make,
is.
Like, really gruesome
funny.
Things that are really, really gruesome situations.
Yeah.
It's kind of a little bit lighthearted.
Yeah. You probably like, then, My Favorite Murder. And you would love us giving up the ghost.
Oh, yeah, I'll
of course. Of course you would love us.
Yeah, I would definitely listen.
What was your name?
My name's April.
April? Hi,
yeah.
April. I'm Jazz.
Nice to meet you guys.
This is our friend Jan. She's stepping in for
chair.
Yeah.
What was your name?
Brianna.
Hi,
Brianna. Nice
and
to meet
you.
Are?
Cody.
Hi, Cody. So you want to tell us a quick story? I don't want to
choose. I don't have any good stories.
I feel like you definitely have
good
stories.
No, I just like to collect other people's stories. I like to listen to other people's stories. I don't have any. I don't have any of my own. And like by the time that I like replay other people's stories, it's like I'm missing good details.
Right, I'm not a good storyteller. I don't know.
Yeah, I have like nothing good.
No.
Yeah, I've never even like.
Okay, well, you have a business card. Have you ever?
Yeah, absolutely.
Call. I see something spooky.
Yeah.
Like, I lost it one day. I was driving to Lorette, and I lost my mind. So I pulled over, called my dad. I swear to God, I saw a UFO. Like, it was shooting out of the sky, and it was bright green. And I was like, oh, my God, I finally saw a UFO.
I believe it.
And
or
I called my dad.
It could be a meteor.
And there was a meteor storm in Altona the same night.
Like, I was hoping it was.
I know. I was so excited. I was so excited. But.
Come back. Talk to us after.
Okay.
Yes, for sure.
No, this is fine. What is this?
This one's giving up the ghost?
No, this.
It's just a microphone.
Okay.
Do you care not? Or?
Oh, no, it's fine.
Okay.
Good.
Good.
Can you... Yeah, so you talk about ghosts.
Winnipeg hauntings and paranormal.
Beautiful.
We're Winnipeg's first and only, so far, paranormal podcast. We've been doing this for 19 weeks.
Amazing. Okay.
So, because I found there was no content that I liked.
Okay.
In the States. I mean, that's all good and great, but I'm a very proud Canadian Winnipegger. I want to know what's going on in the backyard, because I know Winnipeg's so haunted. Like,
for
it's
sure.
So haunted, right?
Yeah.
So, in saying that, we do a little... Jen's our backup, and it's usually
backup.
Been Cher. She couldn't make it today.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Jazz.
Oh, sorry.
What's your name?
Kira.
Kira. Hi, Kira. So, we like to do investigation work as far as finding history. Nothing physically to investigate. Like, we've been at the Dalton right yesterday for doors open, and they were welcoming us here, which is great, just to talk to people and, you know, find things out. And we cover, as far as the haunting, like, we do paranormal stuff as well. Like, we look in phenomena. We want to know
for
more
sure.
Hawkeye children and, you know,
oh
all that kind
God,
of stuff,
yes.
Right?
Okay.
So, yeah.
So
but we're only 19 weeks in. We're still getting our groove. I think after the fourth episode, we're way better than, you know.
It takes a couple, and you
sure.
have to find your, yeah. No,
our
that's
niche.
Super
we've
exciting.
We've got a groove now. So,
oh, I'm
yeah.
super excited. Is it on Spotify?
Yes.
Awesome. Okay.
Yes, we're pretty much everywhere.
Awesome.
Player One, Google Play, iTunes, Spreaker is actually our home base.
Okay.
And stuff. So,
do you have an Instagram?
We have Instagram.
Okay, perfect.
There we are.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
and
what we try
to do, we get an episode out every Monday night, and then we try to match up pictures with the episode on Instagram with the show description, and we hashtag anybody and everybody that's associated that we've either interviewed or places we've been and
okay.
stuff. So yeah, hope you enjoy it.
No, I'm really excited. This is great. Thank you.
Yeah.
I have like one weird podcast and it's like I'm trying to
dwell
find more.
Kind of, yeah. Which one is it if you don't mind me asking?
The What If podcast.
The What If. I think I heard that one.
It's
yeah.
really good. And yeah, they just talk about weird stuff. And
yeah, there was a couple of good ones. They're on hiatus now. I kind of liked it, but sometimes the hosts kind of wear on me. Like, I hope we're not too obnoxious. We drink and swear.
Beautiful.
So, you know, yeah.
Not for my students, but for me.
No, no.
While I run.
We, you know, and we've had some people, we had great feedback the first few weeks saying, oh, it's just like sitting around with girls and banter and stuff. So we kind of go off topic and then we bring it back.
Perfect.
We've had guests. Jen was one of our guests. She's a first responder, so she's seen some really crappy shit.
For sure.